Father! Father!
What, my son? What happened?
There is a man lying down at the streets, injured, and he is beaten up by the robbers.
You kids are making me so proud. God bless you.
Father, are you happy for us?
Yes, my dear. No doubt on that.
Then why would you mind telling us a story?
Ha ha ha. There you are. Come, let's go. And definitely I shall. Shall I start? But this is a pretty longer one. Is that okay with you?
Yeah.
Jesus loved to tell a good story to make a point. And the Good Samaritan is one of his most famous stories of all. One day, someone asked Jesus,
"Which of the Old Testament commandments is the most important?"
"Love the Lord, your God, with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and love your neighbor just as much as you love yourself."
Love can mean many different things, but the Christian love that Jesus talked about means treating others with kindness and respect and helping them when they need it. It is the kind of love we do instead of the kind of love we feel. Love your neighbor as yourself was part of the Old Testament law, Leviticus 19:18, that was sacred to Jesus' kinflock, the Jews. But many people thought a neighbor meant only the fellow Jews. Same way, a lawyer asked Jesus,
"And who is my neighbor?"
Jesus told the story of the Good Samaritan to answer his question in a way we can never forget. A Jewish man was taking a trip alone and was attacked by robbers. They beat him, robbed him of everything he had, and left him nearly dead beside the road. After a while, a Jewish priest came along and saw the poor man lying beside the road. As a religious man, you would expect him to stop and do what he could to help. But instead, he kept going and pretended he did not see. Later, a Levite came along. Levites were assistant to the priest, so you would expect him to stop and help too. But he did just as the priest and kept on going. Finally, a Samaritan man came by. Even though they both lived in the land of Palestine and shared a similar religion, the Jews and the Samaritans definitely did not think of each other as neighbors. In fact, they hated each other. The Samaritans came from a different race of people than the Jews. They had considered each other enemies for hundreds of years and refused to even talk to each other. You would expect the Samaritan man to be the one who just passed by without helping. Instead, this Samaritan man took pity on the injured Jewish man.
"Oh my God, what have they done to this man?"
He bandaged his wounds. He put him on his donkey and took him to an inn where he could be safe and recover. Since the injured man had been robbed of everything he had, the Samaritan man even paid the bill at the inn and paid the innkeeper.
Take good care of him.
After telling the story, Jesus turned to the lawyer who had asked,
"And who is my neighbor?"
and said to him,
"Now, which of the three men that passed by was a neighbor to the injured man?"
The lawyer was forced to admit that it was the Samaritan who treated the injured man as a neighbor, not his fellow Jew who did nothing to help. Jesus then said,
"Yes, now go and do the same."
Kids, are you ready?
Yeah, we are.
Tell me, who our neighbors are?
All the other people who are other than us, who are oppressed, who are depressed, and the needy.
There you go, my so wonderful. have these chocolates for you, and don't forget to share with your friends. If a Samaritan could be a neighbor to a Jew, and Jesus told us to go and do the same, then all of God's people must be our neighbors, and we must love them just as the Samaritan man did. Yet, Christians, Muslims, Jews, Catholics, Protestants, African Americans, Native American, Hispanics, Asians, the poor, the homeless, the unattractive, the handicapped, the mentally ill, and countless other groups are still sometimes the victim of ridicule, hatred, and discrimination. Jesus must be looking down with sadness that after 2,000 years, we still have not learned to love our neighbors. I need some rest now. Can I take leave of you? You can play here, but don't shout, right? Yeah.
Yeah, Father.